So look at this myriad of colours I've got to choose from. Very, that's lovely green, isn't it? But you see, Simon, that is my spectrum.
Perfect.
Yeah.
I'm going grey. Literally. Literally and on the ribbon.
Well, I'd call it pewter. Pewter, I'd call it pewter. I think you're turning into Gloria Swanson. She never had grey hair. It was pewter.
Right, so we've got our ribbons. So you've got a really lovely, slender ribbon here, which is perfect because you're just going to snip yourself off a short length of ribbon. And then where's your little bunch of pre-wired cinnamon, please? And then you're just going to go around there and just cover your wire. Another little tie like that, and then you might need to just pull your wire up. In fact, I'm going to be reckless, seeing as it's you and it's Lana's Lit and Learning, we're going to be extravagant. We're going to use twice as much of that ribbon. Reckless edge I've got.
I'm like the girl from L'Oreal, it's because I'm worth it.
Exactly. So look, we go bandy bindy round, so there, no chance of those wires showing, and then snippy off. And again, these are like the pine cones. Once you've wired them and put your ribbon on, if you salvage these from your wreath at the end of Christmas, pop them in the Christmas box and they'll be all good to go next year.
Fantastic.
And then just give those a little, are you a fishtail or on an angle?
Well, I don't mind. A fishtail is always welcomed. And I've quite enjoyed being on an angle at sometimes.
So there you are.
Now you add
that in. So what you do is basically you make up a little selection of these and then you use
just
some of
them.
Your lovely ribbon to hide them.
Right.
Hide that wire.
So, Simon, I'm using these scissors or shears.
Lovely florist scissors, very sharp.
Yeah. Oh, so they're special floristry scissors,
they are.
These.
Yeah, so they'll cut through nice, stiff stems and wires, but they're relatively comfy in your hand. They don't give you blisters. I hope you're not blistered of hand.
No. No, but my hands are all right at the moment. In fact, you know, I found it quite surprising that it's not been more taxing on the fingers.
Oh, good.
Doing
I think that's probably because you're relatively practical with your hands and doing stuff anyway.
Yeah. Yeah, that's probably the answer.
Because it is quite... I mean, the wiring is quite tough on the hands. The resin and pine, you too can have hands like this for Christmas.
Yeah. Do you take care of your hands, though?
Don't you give them a manicure?
Oh, I hate
a manicure.
Oh, do you?
Sets my teeth on edge, all that quick poking.
Oh! No! Well, I only go for the poking, really. But there you go. Let me put some more of these on. So, Simon, are you doing any more of that American show for HBO, Full Bloom?
Well, we filmed season one and season two, and we are waiting to hear, keeping it all crossed, if season three is going to happen.
Oh, wow.
I know. So I might be back out to LA to film.
Oh, fantastic.
It's wonderful. I mean, what's lovely about it is it gives a window into the world of forestry. And I do think forests are artists.
Of course they are.
So it gives that opportunity for people to see just how incredible it is. And there are 10 florists competing for $100,000, which is not an insubstantial sum of money, life-changing, let's be honest. And I'm the host and one of three judges on it.
Wonderful. And so you obviously fly out for that,
yes,
don't you?
I do.
That is incredible. That's fantastic.
And everybody says, what's it like in LA? And I say, I've no idea, because I've only ever filmed in lockdown.
Yeah.
So we're bubbled whilst we're there. So I don't really know what being out on the town in LA and Hollywood is like.
Well, hopefully this next time
we should be a little bit more
do like the touristy thing. I want you to go to the Ravenswood.
Right.
The building that Mae West used to own. Because Mae is one of my spirit guides.
All right.
And I want you to go around the apartment.
Oh, okay.
And see if you can pick up anything.
All right.
You know,
oh,
like an old feather bell.
Yeah, exactly.
Like that. But you have to visit that building. Because apparently a ghost still walks around.
Oh.
That building.
A ghost of Mae West.
A ghost of Mae.
Saying, come up and see me sometime.
Yeah. But I should probably be saying, come down and see me sometime. You know. Don't get in line, boys. Get online.
So, how are you doing with your cinnamon? Doesn't it smell yummy? I think it is.
It really complements that tangerine, doesn't it?
And also, it's a different shape again. So, let me show you what you've done.
Oh, yes. This is one I did earlier with the grey ribbon. Yeah. Oh, that's gorgeous, isn't it? Wow.
Now, the last thing we're going to do
is
finish off with a bow.
Oh.
So, the secret to making a fabulous bow is to be extravagant with the ribbon.
Right.
Which, let's be honest, it's Christmas time, we want abundance.
Yes.
And you can reuse your ribbon and you can reuse your bow. I've got sticky tape stuck on my finger, get off. And your scissors are newer and sharper, so I'm going to use these. And we decided we liked a fishtail, didn't we?
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to do a little bit of that. If you get into the habit, every time you cut your ribbon, of always cutting the finish you want on it, you never end up cutting that bit away and throwing it in the bin to make that end.
Right.
Top tip. Another, that's the second.
That's it. Get it all here.
It's no lie when they say lit and learning, is it?
It's absolutely.
No word of a lie. So we cut ourselves a piece.
Yes.
And we pop that to one side. Then we take our ribbon.
Mm-hmm.
And we do what the Americans call cinch, but I would call gather.
Right.
So we gather it in.
As in return.
Yes.
So we gather.
We gather.
Yes, we gather what you're saying, Simon. Yes.
And then we make ourselves a little loop.
Yes.
And we gather.
Right.
And then over to this side.
Mm-hmm.
And we make ourselves another little loop.
Yes.
And we gather. And we repeat. I reckon you want to do at least 6 loops.
Right.
To feel fulsome and gorgeous.
Right.
And a tiny bit Pussycat Mrs. Slocum.
Yes.
It needs to be, I think.
Yes, Mr. Humphreys, yes. And did you leave your pussy out all night, our Simon?
Amazing what they used to say.
Well, honestly,
I'm glued to Are You Being Served most evenings as I cook supper.
Yeah.
I cannot believe what they got away with.
I know. And all that innuendo was just so overt, wasn't
yes.
it? And also, I mean, it's...
But was it only watched by nuns? How did no one know?
Well, a bit like Julian and what's his name?
Julian and Sandy. On Round the Hall.
Yeah, and just nobody got the fact that they were, you know, gay, that they were these two really outre queens, you know.
I mean, it was extraordinary and hilarious. I've just cinched that in. So there's my loops and I've just put a wire around it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm now going to trim this off. And then, do you remember we cut ourselves a piece of white ribbon initially?
Yeah.
So that goes around.
At the centrepiece.
At the centrepiece to hide the little gathering of wire. And also to replicate the sort of knotty effect that you would get if you were tying a bow. And then on the reverse, we literally just tie it off like that. And there we have our beautiful bow.
It is.
With our little trails.
Uh-huh.
And we're now just going to tuck this into our wreath. I'm going to tuck it into your wreath here while you make a bow to go on mine. There you go.
Lovely.
And there is your bow. Put it in and then you can just manipulate your loops.
Uh-huh.
Matron.
Yes. I mean, you're nothing if your loops haven't been manipulated. Have you manipulated your loops lately? So, and where am I putting this, then?
Wherever you want. Let me hold my wreath up for you to look and see where you think a bow would look great.
Well, actually, what if it went there? I think it should go in here.
Okie doke. So, pop it down on the table to insertify it.
Right.
So, and go sort of slightly above the middle line.
Right. Lovely. Look how lovely your bow is.
Well, I chose a wider ribbon.
Yeah.
But also, I think that's gorgeous because that colour palette is beautiful.
Mm.
You just need to twist it so that it's this away.
Yeah. And you get a bit of the centre showing.
Mm. Definitely you want that.
Yeah.
Right. So, I'll hold up your wreath, you hold up my wreath, and let's see what we think about it.
Oh, yes.
There what you do you think, viewers?
Isn't that amazing? Thank you, Simon, that's amazing. What I do need to ask you, though, is, because they're quite heavy now, how do we hang them on a door? What's the best method for that?
The best method for that is, I'm going to take you to my door and show you now.
Oh, okay. So if you take mine, then.
I'll bring your wreath over.
Thank you.
Walk this way.
Thank you.
Come with, viewers. So if you imagine this is your front door.
Yes.
What you don't want to do is hammer a nail in here, because that would look unsightly for the rest of the year.
Right.
And that's glass, so we can't.
Right.
So you draw in, pin your length of ribbon into the top of the door there,
right,
the door jamb.
Yes.
And then down comes your ribbon.
Yeah.
You suspend your wreath on it, and then you draw in, pin your ribbon back at the top. So your wreath is hanging wherever you want,
right,
at whatever height.
Uh-huh.
And then afterwards, you just rip that ribbon out, and there's no marking of your paintwork.
There you go.
And if you have a metal door, and you can't attach on the top, you have to make two wreaths. And you hang them on one length of the ribbon, one on the outside, one on the inside. Bob's your uncle.
And Charlie's your aunt. So Simon, would you kindly do the honours and sprinkle some of your magic dust to get me back to my front door to hang this on?
Of course.
Here it is. The beautiful winter solstice Yuletide wreath hanging where it should be hanging on my door. And it just looks fantastic. And isn't it really generous of Simon Lycett, to provide all the materials as he taught me how to make the perfect wreath. And I just think it's fantastic. Beautiful, and I love the art and artistry of floristry. And actually, what it's done is made me want to sing a festive song. So I think I'll look to the Johnny Mathis book of music and try and pick something out. Maybe the hit that he had that Christmas in 76, worldwide number one hit. That Christmas in 76, when a child is born, that's what I'll go for.
A ray of hope flickers in the sky, a tiny star lights up way up high. All across the land dawns a brand new morn. This comes to pass when a child is born. A silent wish sails the seven seas. of change whispers in the trees, and walls of doubt crumble, tossed and torn. This comes to pass when a child is born. A rosy hue settles all around. You've got the feel, you're on solid ground. For a spell or two, no one seems forlorn. This comes to pass when a child is born. Child is born.